This MooseCast is brought to you by Broken Cherry, boutique, design studio, and custom apparel. For the coolest in Derby Girl merchandise, go to shop.brokencherry.com, where the Derby family always gets a 10% discount. Just use the Derby Rocks discount code at checkout and tell them Moose sent ya. This is Ondaluce coming to you from the Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Madison, Wisconsin, the site of Derby in the Dairyland, the WFTDA Eastern Regional Tournament. With me, of course, this is your home turf, Bob Noxious. Bob, how are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you, Moose?
Tired. Been putting up a lot of MooseCast this week.
Yeah, I can only imagine.
Well, I put up MooseCast from last week in Houston, where the Bay Area Derby Girls, the Bay Area Derby Roller Girls, Duke City, the shocker of the event, and Rat City, and of course the Texecutioners that took it all home last week. Who should we be looking out for here?
Well, there's no question, Moose, that the juggernaut here is Gotham. You know, Gotham is the one person you take a look at the bracket, and people are probably circling to take this thing. Otherwise, everybody that's not playing Gotham is in a cage match. It literally is going to be one of the most intense sets of bouts, I think, that we will see.
Well, you know, last week, you know, the Kansas City Roller Warriors, number one last year, were upset by Duke City.
Yeah, well, and, you know, which goes to show you that nobody is a lock. I mean, Madison was number one in the East last year, and we lost our first game. Gotham looks pretty strong. Something could happen. I think Kansas City showed us a little bit of that weakness when they went to Chicago, even though they didn't have their full team. Duke is a team that people probably don't know enough about. They're a very good team. It was an upset, there's no question. It didn't shock me, like knock me over. But yeah, it definitely was something that none of us probably expected.
Any dark horses here?
Yes, definitely. Absolutely. Boston. Boston has already played Grand Raggedy. Grand Raggedy is a fine team. It was neck and neck for 10 minutes, and then they busted it open by almost 100 points.
Wow.
Yeah, absolutely. And we have to remember, Boston lost to Detroit in overtime last year, so Boston would have been in the Nationals had they won that game. So Boston was that close last year, and we have a tendency to forget about that. I think that...
Do you have chili for breakfast?
I think that Madison could be that surprise if they can get by Gotham. Whereas Boston, I don't believe, has to go that route. Madison obviously has to. That's our next game. Cincinnati, there's potential there. Charm City, Philadelphia. It goes on and on and on. I would say out of the 12 teams here, there are 10, depending on how you mix up the brackets, that would have the ability to get to the last four and make it to the Nationals.
Well, it's going to be a real exciting weekend. Two weekends in a row for the Moose, so I'm running on vapors right now, but we're going to make it through. Let's take you now to some of the interviews with some of the skaters.
Hey, this is the Reverend Almighty with Derby News Network, sitting here talking to Sass E. McNasty, captain of the Rhode Island Riveters. Sassy, how'd it go out there today?
Actually, even though we lost, we feel like we really played a good game. I'm really proud of our girls and how well we did, especially in the second half. I think we really picked it up.
You definitely did. In the second half, the defense held strong. Now, Providence wasn't even supposed to be here. They were ranked 13th in the East. Tell me a little more about that.
Old Dominion was supposed to come. They were ranked 12th, and because of different issues in their league, they weren't able to come. We were really bummed that we didn't get that 12th place. We kept checking the site to upload the rankings, and when we didn't make it, we were really disappointed, understandably. So about 6 weeks ago, when I got the email that Dominion was dropping out, we get a chance to be here, we just wanted to prove that we deserved it in the first place. Old Dominion lost to Detroit by, I think, about 100 points, and we just wanted to do better than that to prove that we were supposed to be here in the first place.
You definitely did better than that. It was 124 Detroit. Providence 70 points, that is definitely not a bad way to lose a roller derby bout. So the season was over, you guys were packed up, you were heading home, you come back, you're at Eastern Regionals, you just played Detroit, and now we got Grand Raggedy coming up. What do you think about Grand Raggedy?
I think they better watch it.
Sass E. McNasty tells you Grand Raggedy, she is ready, you better watch it. Once again, Sassy McNasty, captain for the Rhode Island Riveters, the Reverend Almighty Providence Roller Derby. Back to Moose. Thank you, everybody.
This is Big Poppa Razzi, announcer for the Detroit Derby Girls. I have the prestigious pleasure of standing here with the captains of Detroit, Racer McChaser, number 2.8, and Cookie Rumble, number 33 1/3. These are the Detroit girls that came in fourth place in Eastern Regionals last year. They just played their first game against Providence in a score of 124-70 in favor of Detroit. Racer, how did you feel your team came together in that game?
We had a little bit of trouble staying together and stuff, but we were able to pull off the win, so now we're moving on to play Philadelphia tomorrow morning at 8.
And Cookie Rumble, how'd you feel your team came together?
Well, all we did was just take a couple seconds to, like, take a deep breath, calm down, and say, you know what, we know what we're doing, we know why we're here, let's just go out there and kick some butt.
Now, there's some rumor that Detroit is now coached under new management by Coach Robbie McSpeedypants, who is actually a speed skating coach, and he's bringing a little bit of that to Detroit, and you guys have been working with him to keep your penalties down. How's that working out for you?
It seems to be working out for us pretty good. Game we played against Texas about a month ago, we had the least amount of penalties and actually had less penalties than they did, which was surprising, so it's pretty good for us.
I actually heard Detroit celebrated that fact alone when they went to the afterball party. Is that true?
That is correct. Actually, I had special drinks all around for that one, but unfortunately this game, it was not the case.
They had a little bit of penalty trouble, but Detroit is working on it, as you can clearly see by Cookie Robot over here doing the robot dance. This is actually what Detroit does to prepare for bouts. They don't even skate most of the time, they just go out and do robot dances. I've seen it. So guys, what are you looking forward to tomorrow at 8 in the morning when you're facing Philly?
Breakfast!
Yeah, breakfast.
Breakfast?
Yeah, I know.
Before or after the game? Breakfast during the game is how Detroit is planning to take on Philadelphia. Coming up tomorrow at Eastern Regionals 2008, right here in Madison, Wisconsin, at Derby and Dairyland. This is Poppa Razzi for the Detroit Derby Girls here with Cookie Rumble and Razor McChaser, and we're signing off. Check out all your Derby news on DNN, DerbyNewsNetwork.com.